Okay, folks, now I am on the banks of the Burhi Gandak, which the local, iska naam kya hai? Sikrana. The local people call it Sikrana. Now it has, see, the whole river is called Burhi Gandak, which comes from Nepal. But this area calls it Sikrana. Now it has something to do, that word I have to decipher the meaning. It has something to do with Lord Buddha, Pyas Bujhana, Sikrana, Pyas Bujhana. Anyway, crossing, he crossed the river. Kitna dur hai yahan se? It's around a half kilometer. So he crossed the river and he stayed in Cundaka's mango grove. Now see these temple, Goraiya Baba ka Goraiya Baba ka kon now these people are the local kon jati ke log sab reh jate Jadav, they are Jadavs. And I had that theory that the Yadavs also, they prayed, they followed the Buddha. So basically, their local deity, their ancestor, is a gentleman called Goraiya Baba. See, the local, the village deity is Goraiya Baba. And what do you call it? Goraiya Baba. Are Banni Mai? Banni Mai. Now, Goraiya Baba sounds very similar to the Buddhist Cundaka. They say, according to Buddhist scriptures, the Buddha crossed over the Kukkuta River. The Gandak River, he calls it Buddhists mispronounce it as the Kukkuta River. Up here it is called Sikrana. And he crossed over and stayed in Cundaka's house and a mango grove. Now Cundaka mango grove, this is Gudra. So it is clean. This Gudra is a mispronunciation. Cundaka is a mispronunciation of Gudra, and their kul devta, their ancestor, Goraiya Baba.
Goraiya Baba. Goraiya
Baba is what do you call it? Cundaka is a Buddhist, foreign Buddhist mispronunciation of Goraiya. Cundaka is a mispronunciation of Goraiya Baba. See, the Sira is the ancestor. So Goraiya Baba was the ancestor, and the Buddhists say the Lord Buddha stayed in Cundaka's mango grove. So folks, this is the land which was the mango grove. And the Buddha crossed from that side. He crossed from that side. The river is around half a kilometer away. The Kukkuta River or the Burhi Gandak or the what the locals call it Sikrana. So folks, see, now of course, it's unique. This small, out-of-place village has such got such huge temples. That means, basically, at some time of history, this was a very important place. Understand? But when Buddhism got wiped out, people forgot these stories. But people held on to their Kuldevta, to their ancestors' name. Understand? So, that's it. Thank you.